Hello and greetings from Iceland, but today's video is all about to go with the lava flow. But the little storage that we have there between the mountains is just about full and the lava field is 8 meters thick already and the overspill, it is going to take off from here. So, does it pose a threat to infrastructure or something else? And like last year, maps can often explain things better than videos. So I'm starting with the topography map and I have outlined the lava field from last year and the new fissure is getting shorter and taking the shape of a cone. But when the eruption started, the flow was around 30 cubic meters per second, but it was soon down to 18. But it has been hard to make any measurements for the last 2 days due to weather. But we do know that this is the spillover and it's just a matter of hours and days when the lava comes down through that little pass and it might even close the south coast road, but let's see what you already know and swap to this view. But this image is shot from the north and if the fissure would have come up just a few hundred meters further north, this would have been the path of the lava toward us. And that is still a possible scenario because last year new vents just kept on popping up. But let's look at it from the south now. This is from where the lava will come down and it won't accumulate in this valley for long. It's no such obstacles. And as I move further down on this image, it's the same thing. The lava will move beside this old lava field from the 12th century and more or less follow the road. And then when I turn southeast, it's about here where the lava will go over the south coast road. And what is the damage is the next obvious question. And there are three things to consider. The road is only around 10 years old and it replaced a road from 1946 that was so miserable that its name will live forever. It was called the Krisuvik road and often when we Icelanders encounter time-consuming problems in our lives, we tend to say this will be the Krisuvik road. But today it has another name, the South Coast Road, and as for its importance, it's used a lot for fish transport and it shortens the road from Keflavik International Airport to the South Coast as it's possible to use it to bypass the city. And it is also a secondary road to Reykjavík from the South Coast since a part of that road tends to close often during winters due to the elevation as we drive over the plate boundaries just before we enter the city. But as for tourism, where the lava is flowing, they will come the longer way or the shorter way. We have seen that very well for the last days and actually a bit too much of it. But overall, we can handle it to lose this road for some months. But it might be expensive for some companies around. And the second risk is the fiber optic cable. Again, it's just a part of a network, so it could be worse. But last year, a part of the fiber optic cable by the South Coast was dug down deep and isolated as a test project that never gave us any feedback because the lava stopped just a few hundred meters away from it. So they might try something of that kind now, or to isolate the cable where the lava would flow over it. So those are very minor issues, especially when we think of La Palma last year. But what might be the biggest loss is an old fishing station by the coast. Archaeologists did some work last year in order to prepare for the worst case scenario, but this is the best preserved fishing station that we have, most likely for the reason that it's so rural and cannot be seen from the highway. And as for the history, fishermen in such fishing stations drowned by the thousands, and the 1900s alone took around 3,500 lives, or until the fishing boats got bigger. So this is a place of history, or something that we can't replace. But it's however too early to say what path the lava would take. It can be as little as a few days until the lava hits the South Coast Road, but it could also be weeks. But this eruption did however start like 5 to 10 times stronger than last year, and I think it's going to be a larger event that will go on for months or even years. So I'm curious to see what the civil defense is going to do about this. They were looking around up there today, trying to figure out what to do if something can be done, but I think it's impossible to try to block the valley or something like that. Lava is heavier than it appears because it's basically liquid rock and more dense than cement. But lava walls and ditches could divert the lava up to some limit. It worked around here last year, but other barriers failed and the remaining barrier might not have worked for so much long time. So ditches and a wall might be a solution that could work down there for a while, at least to try to divert the lava from the old fishing station and into the ocean. But only a few hundred meters away from the coast, the ocean gets quite deep, so we would not get so much new land, or perhaps just 200-400 meters long lava tongue. And it is very strange to look at this happening, especially since I know this place quite well. And this boat was my workplace for a while, but we sailed from Grindavík, and I have to say that I've had better jobs. But this is more or less the situation now. I'm sure that our institutions have better data than me to calculate the lava flow from minor details in the landscape. But I think I managed to show you the bigger picture quite accurately. And I am in North Iceland now. I had to do some work up here. The weather was terrible back south, so I had to delay other photo projects as well. But the summer is coming to an end soon, and I'm getting a bit worried that I won't be able to capture all the summer footage I planned to get to edit this winter, because good light has been hard to find recently. But it looks a bit better now, so after some more editing and car fixing, after some awful roads, I'm going out again. Back south to the volcano, but the best has yet to come, and if you're on your way to Iceland to see this, don't be crying over those first few days, because visually this will only get better as the lava takes off the longer way under the northern lights, and we hope that it won't do too much damage and it still looks all good. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.